Good morning and welcome back to Stationery at 4. It's been a minute. In fact, I think it's been almost 3 months since I posted my last video. There's been a few things going on in my life, nothing major, nothing serious, just a lot of busyness and activity that's really taken off with all the spring weather, I suppose, and it's been warmer than usual this spring, and so there's also been a lot of being outdoors and things like that happening. I'm gonna share all that in today's video. Well, not all of it, but a good chunk of it in terms of what's been going on and some of the things that have been keeping me busy. But I'm gonna do it in my style. I've done sort of video log styles before, but they've been journal with me's, and that's typically been done while we're out camping. And camping season is coming up upon us here in the next couple months as well, so there's gonna be a few more of those videos. But I'd love to share a little bit about what has been keeping me busy, random activities and events and things like that, and also getting sick, which hasn't been really helpful. And there's also some stationary things involved inside of all that, or in the midst of all that. I got this really cool stamp from Paper Yaa in Vancouver. It's just a month, day, year stamp. It's another stamp that I got from Paper Yaa in Vancouver. Just a month, day, year, and this is the Screaming Lady. I believe that's it. Just thought it was really cool. And since the theme is what have I been up to, I'll use Screaming Lady. Can't believe we're almost at the end of May here. It seems like it's just going so fast. So I'm gonna draw a few things. I had to get out to Vancouver for a bit of a last minute unscheduled or unplanned rather for work. So I spent a week out there and I had the opportunity. It was mainly just a solid work trip, very little opportunity to do much else. For you folks out there who've got kids, it seems like everyone with kids is just constantly sick, and that certainly is what it felt like for me. Just as I was leaving for an early flight out from Calgary, I felt kind of sick, but nothing too crazy. Oh yeah, and I'm wearing one of my favorite jackets. If you're wondering, from time to time I wear this really bulky Carhartt jacket. And I was inspired by Matthew McConaughey's look in Interstellar. He's an engineer. And while I'm an engineer, I'm also a self-proclaimed not the most detail-oriented engineer, but nonetheless, the movie Interstellar really, really resonated with me, especially the jacket. Watching Interstellar, which is one of my favorite all-time movies. I can watch that movie over and over. And I took it with me to Vancouver. That's the only reason I'm talking about it because, well, two reasons. I'm wearing it in this video, clearly, because we're getting ready to do a full day of landscaping in our front yard. We're slow landscapers. It's been a project that we've been putting off for many. Well, I wouldn't say putting off. We've been slowly tinkering at it. My wife and I are. We like to do all the landscaping ourselves and not pay for that necessarily, so taking our time. I took that jacket also to Vancouver. That's the second reason I'm talking about it. But halfway through my trip, and this is always embarrassing, I got really sick. I got feverish to the point where I just could not function anymore. It was that bad. I remember taking lots of drugs to try and just keep powering through the work week. But eventually at 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock on a Wednesday, I can't remember, I ended up having to just go back to the hotel. And I was so feverish, I curled up in a ball and my on the floor by the window. And the reason I'm telling the story is because I had the lovely opportunity to see the sunset over English Bay. And for those of you who don't know Vancouver, it's right by the it's a coastal city and it's right on the ocean there. The hotel that I was staying at, I was lucky enough, somehow I lucked out and I got a view. in my room of English Bay. And English Bay looks like it's just magnificent. And there's rolling hills and mountains. But the cool thing about Vancouver is it's hill, mountain, ocean, water. It's kind of all of the above. And it's just incredible to have been a witness to that. And there's beaches and such. And lots of ships. Definitely lots of ships. So let me just start on that side here. And I'm just giving you a feel for... There's lots of cargo ships that come into port over there, as they say. It was really beautiful to kind of see the container ships lit up against the sunset. Well, Vancouver is such a sprawling city. It's actually made up of different cities. Please excuse my rudimentary rough windows. The view from my room was spectacular. As I was curled up in the fetal position, feverish out of my mind, I was at least taken away by the beauty of the sunset that was unfolding in front of me. Over this wonderful... wonderful bay. It's just lush out there, which is really, really neat. And English Bay is a little bay, obviously, but it breaks out into the ocean, and so you can really see some beautiful oceans or ocean vista out there. And that was roughly my view from the hotel as I was curled up, and so I just watched this beautiful sunset. That was kind of my trip out there, more or less. But the repercussions of all of this, which is what I'm trying to build to in my little story here, is the fact that I came back to Calgary really, really sick, to the point where I had to actually take some time off from work, more than I had anticipated. And as such, I ended up even going to the doctor, and it turned out I had a secondary infection. Family got really sick at the same time. There's a theme of sickness that went on here. Clearly an artist. I got chicken toes and weird hand things going on here, but that gives you the idea in terms of something. Sick. And ended up taking some time off work. It turns out I had a secondary infection. The infection was in my lungs, so I was on inhalers, the whole bit. So I'm kind of working backwards a little bit here, or maybe I'm jumping all over the place. One of the things that having the time off allowed me to do was really get back into reading. And before the Vancouver trip, or somewhere around there, I also had the instinct to finally cave in and pick myself up a Kindle, just because I've been traveling so much and there's lots of commute time involved in my life right now, and the fact that I love reading. And I haven't been reading as much as I wanted to in the last couple of years, and so I picked up a Kindle, which I'm really enjoying. I did actually have a Kindle from many years ago, I think probably when they first came out, then I didn't really use it. But the new version of the Kindle that I ended up picking up is really nice. It's got the warm light, larger screen, and the fact that I can borrow books from the library has been really wonderful as well. I mainly read nonfiction, but time to time I do read some fiction. This is the Kindle. The reason I'm showing it is because of this awesome sticker of Baby Yoda, Grogu, and drinking a cup of coffee, which is what I usually do with my Kindle. And I just love it. It's just such a great Great device. It's even got a dark mode here. Love the warm light. Reading some Harry Potter for my kids. Reading some stuff on parenting and management and cosmic perspectives and things like that. So it's been really, really, really cool to have something that's nice and portable. And I feel the only reason I'm discussing it, other than the fact that I showed Grogu there, is I generally prefer hardcover books. I love the tactile sensation of paper in my hands. The one compromise I seem to have done here is with the Kindle, and it's just so readily accessible, and some of the books I like to read are really, really fat and big, and I enjoy that. And so being on the go and things like that has been really, really nice to have the portability and the volume capability of the Kindle. I don't know if I've ever discussed it on this channel. My wife and I lost our cat. He died last October. He was a really important member of our family, and what makes him truly uniquely special is that he was the cat that my wife and I picked out on our honeymoon. Long story short, we ended up adopting two new cats this past month, 2 months, roughly somewhere in there. They're adorable cats. I'm gonna totally butcher how to draw cats here. One is a kittenish, 7 months, 8 months old. The other one's a little over a year old. It took us a while to name the cats, but we got there. Between the kids and preferences and what that would look like. But one guy, his name is Midnight, and he's super cute and adorable and a troublemaker. I don't know why my cat looks like he's standing up there. Midnight does actually look like he's standing up a lot. And he's kind of got a funny looking head. He's a black cat. The other one is, his name's Shadow. And he's a Siamese cross. He's a lovely cat. And he's got blue eyes, really, really piercing blue eyes. Part of that Siamese heritage, I suppose. And the other striking thing about Shadow is that he's got a mix of color in him. A little bit of gray, a little bit of black, a little bit of white. His paws are nice and white. The rest of him has got this like light brown ash gray thing going on. In terms of stationery. Oh, I guess the other thing I should mention is the other thing that's been really keeping me busy is my company has been kind enough to pay for a course that I've been wanting to take for a little while now. And it's been really fun to get back and studying Usald stationery toolkit that I have built up over a number of years here. And that's been really fun. So speaking of stationery, it's springtime. And one of the things that I tend to do comes every spring is buy new ink. I picked up a bottle of Diamine Rider's Blood, which I absolutely love. It's a fantastic purple red. Picked up a bottle of Oxblood, which is a drier red, which I really like. And then I picked up a Waterman Mysterious Blue, just a standard blue ink. I needed a good rich blue that, and a lot of it, just based on the study work that I am doing and some of the work stuff that I'm doing as well. A Majestic Blue, which I really, really enjoy. And it's got a nice sheening capability in there. The other one here is a Saragossa C by Diamine. Really, really like it. And my last ink, and I've been eyeing this one for a while, is a Hana Ikada from Hiroshizuku. This is a beautiful cherry blossom pink, and I've been wanting to pick one up. My wife and I, a couple years ago, planted a muckle plum tree in our front yard, which has been blooming a beautiful cherry blossom pink every spring. So spring is in full swing, and a bit of a shout out to Paula, who commented on my channel and sent me a note with her style and categorization and organization of her ink writing. And so I've been trying to mess around with some of the brilliant tactics that she uses and strategies that she uses in her ink writing. And I just wanted to say thank you, Paula, very much for that. And I'm still trying to figure it all out. Between all the different things that I'm juggling, I've been looking at different styles of capturing the ink. So I've got a ink sample writing, and if I've got it inked up, this one's the Writer's Blood, Sargasso Sea, Writer's Blood again in a different nib, Ox Blood, and the Hanakata. Fascinating that I don't have the Majestic Blue and the Mysterious Blue in here. Kind of in a nutshell, some of the stationery toolkit is a lot of inks. The other thing that I have been just recently acquired is some erasable highlighters. Just because I've got a couple textbooks that I'm going through and thought I would try that. So I might do a little bit of a video if I feel like it's worth it in terms of what that looks like in respect to erasable highlighters. I've also got some really cool stickers. Love coffee, and my local coffee shop had these really funny stickers here, a play on pothead, and I just thought it was absolutely hilarious. So I picked up a couple of those. Shout out to a coworker of mine, Andrea. She gifted me this really beautiful bookmark. She's from Ecuador. It's breathtaking. It really is. As I mentioned, I generally prefer hardcover books. I just love that tactile sensation. I'm repeating myself a little bit. One of the draws to hardcover books for me is having really cool bookmarks like that. In terms of currently inked, might as well talk about that. I've got a Konpeki in my Naveler, Sargasso Sea in my Edison Beaumont. I've got a J. Urban Green. I'm totally blanking on the green here, but it's a nice light green in there, although it showed up a little bit darker. The nib on this pen, this is the Monteverde Trees of the World edition. Sometimes it dries out, which I'm noticing a little bit. I've got a Writer's Blood in my Pilot. This is a Pilot Metro, and then a Mysterious Blue in my other Pilot here. So that's generally been it in a nutshell. It's been quite a busy month. We've got some landscaping going on as well right now. We're quite excited about that. We're doing quite a, like I said, we're slow landscapers. We've got the garden beds all set up now with vegetables. That was another thing that I did. And the other thing that I suppose I should mention is last year out of my garage, my bike got stolen, which I was pretty heartbroken about. It was a beautiful hybrid bike, nothing special. It was just a really nice bike that I put a lot of time and energy into. Anyhow, I recently acquired a used bike just because I wanted to get back into biking to work. So I've been doing that quite a bit, and that's been fun and painful because I'm so out of shape. So I've been learning to try and take it easy with my body, I suppose. But yeah, it's been tremendous. Let's see if I can actually draw pedals and a bike. It's nowhere near accurate what my bike looks like, but let's just say that I have a road bike and I've been really enjoying it. And that's it in a nutshell. I've got quite a few activities coming up in the summer months here. We're going to be camping again, as I mentioned, which I'm really excited about. I'll definitely do a couple more Journal With Me videos up in the mountains with the kids. Perhaps we'll go a couple of different areas as well. I've got more videos planned. It's been an unintentional break, where in the sense that I knew I needed a little bit of a break from recording, and then it just spiraled into a longer break from the channel only because I got really sick for a period of time, and then just a few activities, as I mentioned, going on in the background here. So looking forward to taking the camper out this summer. A few more videos planned. The next one I think I'll be doing is on the weekly memo. One of the questions I get quite a bit on is my traveler's notebook and the weekly memo planner and the planning system I use there. I've done a high level run through of it, but I might do a little bit more of a detailed walkthrough. And then of course there's the Show Your Desk video that I still have to get done here, and a couple more things that I've been really wanting to do. Thanks very much for joining me today. I feel like not doing a video in 3 months has gotten me a little bit rusty with all the camera gear and recording, so I hope it turns out all right, and I'm looking forward to a day of landscaping ahead. Take care, have a wonderful day, and bye for now.